Welcome to HeArtfully Creating. Today is part one. Welcome. Meet Howard. Hey, welcome to our creativity zone where HeArtfully Creating is hopes to inspire you to create. So come and see what Anita hopes to inspire your creativity with today. Meet Howard the Turtle, part one. So Howard began, he became Howard the Turtle, because my husband really likes Howard the Turtle and was called that, and it goes back to some CBC channel in Canada back in the late 50s, early 60s, and he was a puppet from a show called Razzle Dazzle. So anyway, most figures start from a drawing or some kind of concept first. I often don't plan things when I create them, but this time I had a goal. He was supposed to be a sea turtle. I started using a more inexpensive Sculpey original. It comes in a box in different sizes. Use wire and foil for underneath figures if you're going to make anything. It helps to make your item lighter, as well as you don't want to put all that clay in there if you don't actually need to. And the framing helps to support things, so you know the neck and things will be strong. And this clay burns easily and is light, so be careful and really follow the directions as far as Primo and other clays go. I always bake them longer to be stronger, but the original stuff does burn, so be careful. So I made the foundation, which is what the white clay and the frame was all about, and then I started mixing the colors that I want. I don't ever really use polymer clay right into the package. I like to mix my own colors, so try playing around with mixing colors. It's a fun thing to do as a painter. That's what I really love to do. So I just started smoothing on the outer layers onto the foundation part and building up his face and neck and indents for the eyes. And I used black onyx beads for the eyes. That's a stone, and I didn't have to use glue or liquid clay to hold them in. Instead, just hold them in by making like anything, like a little bit of clay. So I made eyelids on the top and the bottom just to hold in obviously to give my eyelids, because turtles have eyelids, and it also actually helps hold in whatever inclusion that you're using. So you can make eyes out of beads or polymer beads, polymer clay, you can paint them on if you want, but I thought it would be fun to use some black onyx because it's reflective. And played around with making eyelids. This is my first time ever doing a turtle, so this took like at least 4 weeks maybe. My husband's gonna laugh in the background because he's been here the whole entire way. It's been a long haul. So it was shell making time. I made a frame again using foil and some wire, and just in the shape that I thought would fit Howard. The biggest mistake I made was it's cute that his head turns and all and he has a cute look, but that caused more headaches than anything, but it's all part of the learning process. I could not in the end fit the shell I made up under his chin or cheeks or whatever. So as you'll find later on, stay tuned for part two where we ended up. So I just gotta make sure that the base fits before you start building it up. So again, I covered that foundation with Sculpey original and just a rough shape. Put toilet paper, tissue paper, whatever underneath. It won't burn as long as it doesn't touch the elements. Put them in the toaster oven, and then after that I began to build up some more. So I added, you can use scrap clay if you're going to be covering it, so you don't waste the good clay. So you never waste clay ever. It's always a purpose for it. So I wanted to make them a doodad kind of holder, so I built up the sides. And it's not a true turtle form because I was having fun with it and wanted him to hold things. So to decorate the inside, I did mix some scrapings of some really good pastel, dry pastel. You don't have to use that. You can paint it later if you want. You can use just clay. There's so many options. And I mixed in some glitter because I love glitter. So I do think he looks like a swimming pool, but hey, he looks great. Okay, once I bake that base as well, the glitter is bakeable and the pastel, I added an outer layer to the trinket holder part, or the turtle's body. Underneath looks really sloppy right now, but that's how it goes. I make lots of the foundation and then build up. So what really bothers me if people come and see what I'm working on and they think that that's what it's gonna look like. So I get kind of self-conscious when people are looking at my unfinished work. Then I decided to make pieces to cover a turtle shell. If you notice, it kind of looks tiled and very geometric, or like hexagon, octagon shaped pieces, but I just wanted to be more organic and random. So I made a Makumagane style cane. And that's another topic that's on the HeArtfully Creating blog. So I suggest, if you're interested, look it up. It's a really cool technique. It's super easy. You can't mess it up. And then I adhered it to the baked shell surface. I did make sure the shell surface was smooth first, and used liquid clay and just pieced it together as I went. Had an X-Acto knife or craft knife and just pieced it on, and used a little, I bought a bunch of, there's a lot of cool nail art tools that you can use in polymer clay, including little metal tubes that are great little mini rollers, or you can use a knitting needle or whatever, just kind of roll it flat and make it smooth. It gets kind of shiny because on this shell, yes, there's more than one, let's not go there till later. It's shiny right now, and then, oh yeah, okay, we already jumped. Now I see to the overbaked turtle shell. Well, my husband usually does the baking for me. I was home alone. Don't let me be home alone. I'm only 50, but I turned the oven up to 375 instead of 275 Fahrenheit, and he fried a little bit. But thankfully, as you can see, the outside part was okay. However, the problem I started to discover at this point was, once I added on that next layer, his shell didn't fit right into around his neck. So that's why it became more heart-shaped. And originally, yes, he was a sea turtle. He was supposed to be a gift for someone else, but for a bunch of reasons, I switched him out and made him Howard the Turtle, because my husband said he really liked him. So that's what happened. He got his legs. Actually, those legs I baked on, and I was gonna build them up. I know turtle legs are not that small. And I made him regular four stubby little legs. So he became a land turtle. So he looks pretty happy about it. And then those are the legs. So again, I actually have tinfoil cylinders inside those legs, again, to make it hollow, or not so solid, and solid clay, because solid clay, apparently, when it's really thick, can crack. And then I added an undershell. Turtles have an undershell. Again, he's not meant to be super realistic, but have fun with it. If you're making a character, figurine, animal, have fun. Do it however you want. I definitely went on the internet and looked up reference pictures, and that helped a lot. So I added a tail. Some turtles have different tails. Again, mix a bunch of different types of turtles together. This is Howard the Turtle. This is a unique original turtle. I had to carve and carve and carve to try to fit that shell around his neck because of that turned head. Even though it makes it cute, I couldn't do it, actually. So I did cover the rest of him with some more canes that I made out of clay, using liquid clay. He had more than, oh boy, maybe 5 or 6, quote, facelifts. So again, this was all a learning process. I squeezed a bunch of different colors together to make a cane that I could slice to decorate his legs and underneath his undershell. And yeah, so there's his face, not done. So you'll have to come back for part 2 to see how the rest of it goes. Right on. Thanks for just coming on by, and please like, share, and subscribe, and leave any comments, questions, thoughts, ideas in the comments below. And please check out the corresponding blog that goes with this video at www.heartfullycreating.blogspot.com. And depending what country you're in, blogspot.co, it'll go there. Just type it in Google and it'll go there, or in the address bar. So have a great day. See you at part 2.